Welcome to another video from Greylau 60. I'm by the Yongjiang River once again. It's December the 23rd, and yes, I'm in a t-shirt. Why is that? Because it's like 25 freaking degrees outside. It's beautiful. There's no wind. It's about 85% humidity. You gotta freaking love Nanning. This place is amazing. The restaurants are amazing. The people are amazing. The prices are great. The weather's great. But that's not what this video is about. Making friends in China and the Chinese friends, as far as the Chinese people go, they make friends early in life, in school, grade school, middle school, high school, and they keep those friends forever. Yeah, it's weird. I have friends from grade school that I still consider them my friends, but I don't see them as much anymore. I think it has a lot to do with the family hukou thing here in China. The people stay in one place. They don't travel around the country like they do in Canada. Most of the people that I grew up with in Saskatchewan are living in Alberta now. Yeah, so they don't have as close a ties to the people that they grew up with in their hometown. Most people that watch my channel have learned that a family hukou makes it available for you to live in an area, say Nanning City. If you've got a Nanning City hukou, well, then you get all of the benefits of a Nanning person. Your kids go to school for free. You can own a home. Up until recently, you weren't allowed to own a home if you didn't have a family hukou from Nanning City. Cool, eh? I think it was 2 years ago when that came in. But it just keeps everybody sort of grounded in one place. Sure, people used to move around and put their kids into schools that they had to pay for and stuff, but not as much as in the West. So when you grew up with your group of people, your group of friends, you sort of stick with those group of friends. And I see it with my wife, Wei Fong, all the time. She goes out, like on Friday coming up, she's going out with people that she worked with 20 years ago. Okay, so they became her friends, and they're going out for dim sum, the whole group. Cool. She goes out with her friends from middle school and high school all the time for supper. Cool, you know, so they haven't lost that. Her best friend is somebody that she grew up with and went to middle school with, but not high school with. They've stayed friends for 40 years, you know, type thing, and they spend a lot of time together. In the West, it's a little bit different. But being a foreigner, coming to a place like China, making friends for a foreigner here is challenging. You know, I have friends that are Westerners. I've met a lot of good people in Nanning. I've met people from Britain and Australia and Scotland and Australia. You freaking name it. Canadians and Americans and all of those people. But to meet Chinese people and become friends, it's difficult. And why is that? Well, because we grew up with different ideals, different culture, different understanding. Our schools were different. Our backgrounds, everything was different. But one of the biggest problems in making friends with Chinese people is the language barrier. The language barrier is something that you come up and you're talking to people and you say, well, do you want to be my friend? You know what I mean? And they go, well, but dong, what do you mean? I don't understand what you're saying. And, you know, so even if you did become friends, it would be difficult. Instead of saying you want to be my friend, you look at him and you say, "Ni sang tong wei, wa da peng you ma?" And they look at you like, "Oh, you speak Chinese." And then they start talking Chinese to you, and you say, "Wa budang Chinese." So you know, it's one of those things that the language barrier is a tough one to get by. especially when you want to make friends. I've been lucky. I've got lots of friends here in China, both Western and Chinese people. I got lucky. I know a lot of fairly educated characters, and most of them speak English. It's cut English, but we have same values. We have same understanding. We've, you know, a lot of them have spent time over in the United States, Canada, Great Britain, being educated there. So it makes a big difference, rather than having people that have been in China their whole life and they really don't know the outside world. So how can you relate to these people? Well, basically you can't. A lot of people that I've talked to, Chinese and Westerners, about friendship here in China, let's start with the Chinese. A lot of them say, well, you know, friendship is based on what I can do for you and what you can do for me. And yes, a lot of it is. Not the friendships that are built in school, in grade school and whatever, like Wei Fang has with her friends. But friendships that come later in life in China, a lot of it is, you know, well, I can do this for you. Can you do this for me? And that's how a friendship starts out. Some of them get past that into actual real good friendships, but it's different than in the West. You know, they're a lot of the friendships are based on how much cash you have in your jeans, what stature you have at your job, what education you have, how big your house is, what do you dress, what car do you drive. A lot of things are like that here in China, which is totally the opposite of a place like Canada, where I've got friends that are basically bums. I've got friends that are filthy, filthy rich. I've got friends that are middle class. I've got friends that are mechanics. I got friends that are garbage men. I've got friends all over the spectrum in Canada. And we don't look at money. We don't look at where you live or the house price, the car price, the money in your bank account. We look at the person, and that makes a big difference. So China is different in this aspect. Friendship is different here. So question, Guilao, how many friends have you made since you moved to China here? Just about, well, we're coming on 17 years now. And the answer is, I have no idea. I have a lot of friends. Like, seriously, I'm one of the lucky ones. I have friends from all over the world. I have friends from all over China, actually. And I think a lot of that has to do with, I used to travel around China doing immigration work. So I can go to Taishan or Kaiping, and I've got friends there. I can go to Beijing or Shanghai, and I've got friends there. Yes, even Hong Kong. And Guangxi province for sure, Beihai, yes, up in Yunnan province for sure, because I've assisted their families in helping people from their families move to Canada, to be students in Canada, to work in Canada, to entrepreneurial visas and all of these different things that they feel that brought us closer together, and I feel the same way. All of the people that I dealt with in immigration were good people, and if they weren't good people, I would never have dealt with them. So that's one of the good things that came out of that business is, well, the money was good too, but one of the good things that came out of that business was the friendships that I made all over China with so many different Chinese people, and I cherish that more than I do the money. So I guess maybe the moral of the story is that if you move to a place like China, and you can't live without friends. It's a lonely life, and it's not a good one. Learn some of the language, because without the language, you're not going to be able to talk with people. You're not going to be able to make friends, except for the Westerners that are over here. And you know, a lot of the Westerners are different, and you know, a lot of them are the type of people that you don't want to hang around with. So keep that in mind when you come to a place like China. We have a really good expat. Well, we have a really good expat community in Nanning City, and we have a really bad expat community in Nanning City. It's apparent to me, and I know that because I've been around for so freaking long. I think I've been around longer than any other expat in Nanning City at this point. So I've seen them all come and go, and I've seen the type of people that are here, and the people that I hang out with are sort of the good guys, and I'm sort of happy to have them as my friends. The Chinese people that I hang out with, they're awesome. I enjoy their company. I enjoy their humor. But that's another thing. Their humor is way different than Western humor. So you've sort of got to develop that when you're over here for a long time. You do. I don't know what are you gonna call it? The cultural barriers of understanding how people think is one of those things that takes years and years to figure out. Even with Wei Fong and I, and we've been married for just about 17 years now, we still hit roadblocks in understanding what the other person's thinking. And we have to actually sit down and have a conversation and discuss it, just for the fact that we have to be able to understand each other to the point of coming to conclusions on things. And being husband and wife, that's pretty crucial, because she is my best friend. Of course she is. And that's another video from Guaylao 60. If you like this video, as always, like, comment, subscribe, push that share button, and thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit the bell. And don't forget to resubscribe, because, yes, as always, people are getting unsubscribed. I don't know why they do that. It's got to be some computer glitch. Guaylao, maybe in some weird foreign language, means unsubscribe. I don't know. And never forget to put a couple bucks on the Patreon account for the children. Our Helping Hands Children Foundation is about 41% of our monthly goal. So keep dropping a couple bucks on there. Thanks for watching. Bye now.